One question that I've been asking myself a lot is, could students just get AI to solve complex engineering courseworks? And can AI do it for a challenging module like my own, Applied Advanced Optimization, here at Imperial College London, a top university? This matter is pretty much settled for essay-based courseworks, like those using humanities or business. But what about engineering courseworks that mix coding, mathematics, pattern recognition, analysis of figures and data, and research? I know that many professors and students are asking themselves the same exact question, and a lot of people have strong opinions on this matter. From those who think that AI can solve or will soon solve everything, to those who think that engineering courseworks are too difficult for AI. Well, today we are not just going to ponder the question, but we're going to answer it. I've taken the actual coursework from my course, a coursework that my students spent 2 months to solve at home, and I'm pitting several leading AIs against it. Who will come on top? Can any of them even pass, let alone excel? And well, the results are quite shocking. So what is this coursework about? Students have 2 months to work on a problem of classification. Basically, the students have a bunch of points belonging to 2 classes, and they need to find the mathematical description of a separator. For instance, in this case, the separator is a simple line, while in this other case, it is a circle. There is a rule to follow. They need to learn how to construct classifiers from scratch, using convex optimization, which is the subject of my course. Students are not allowed to use out-of-the-box libraries like scikit-learn that can solve these problems in one line, but they need to formulate convex optimization problems from scratch and then solve them using CVXPy, a convex optimization library. What is the purpose of this coursework? The objective is to challenge the students on an optimization problem that they didn't see before. They need to study some background material on their own, and then they need to code and discuss the answers to 8 questions. Now, and this is crucial, the 8 questions are open-ended. There is no perfect answer to them. There is always more that can be said on every question, more ideas that can be explored, more observation that can be done. In fact, almost all the students in my course can provide an answer to all 8 questions. This is a top university after all, but the difference will be on the quality and depth of their analysis. I'm not going to bore you with the technical details. If you're curious, you can access the coursework questions and all the outputs of the AI from the link down below in the video description. Now, what is the challenge that I pose to the AI? The question is the following. Can someone just copy and paste the responses from the AI without even reading the questions and get top marks? So to clarify, I'm not asking if the AI can help with solving the coursework. Of course, it can help a human to improve the answers. And if from this help the understanding of the students improve, that's okay with me. But the problem arises if a student can copy and paste the result of the AI without having any clue about the coursework. This would be a huge problem and would have big implications that we will discuss later on in the video. So to run this experiment, I established some ground rules. The first rule is that I will not correct the AI. If the AI hallucinates some explanation or data, I will leave that in. Remember, the assumption is that the student does not have any clue about the coursework, so the student cannot help the AI. However, I will give the AI the opportunity to correct itself if the produced code returns a compilation error. Because in that case, the student will know that something went wrong, even if the student does not know what or how to fix the error. This is rule number 2. If there is a compilation error in the produced code, I will first copy the error back into the AI and ask to fix the error. If the AI cannot solve the compilation error, I will try at least once to give a slightly better prompt, because maybe the problem is that I was not clear enough about what I wanted. But if the AI cannot fix the compilation error, even in that case, then I will just leave the compilation error in the submission. Rule number 3. If by running the code this produces a written result, for instance a number that tells us how good the classifier was, I will copy-paste the result back into the AI to get the AI to reflect on the results. This is because otherwise the AI won't know the outcome of the code that it generates and won't be able to comment on it. Rule number 4, and this is an important one. Someone who does not know about this experiment will mark the coursework. I asked my amazing teaching assistants to mark these courseworks, but I did not tell them that these were AI-generated courseworks. This will give us an unbiased assessment of the performance of the AI. Okay, so let's start from the very bottom. Which AI was the worst? The worst AI that I tested was Meta AI. Oh gosh, Meta AI was just a pain to use, and eventually I got tired and gave up halfway. So what were the issues? First, Meta AI already failed at the very first simple question, producing code that did not run. And actually I was surprised by this, because the question was simple. I copy-pasted the compilation error back into Meta AI to correct it, and Meta AI was not able to fix the code. So I tried to improve the prompt, and finally it produced code that ran. To be clear, I used the same initial prompt for all the AIs. I only improved the prompt if the code generated by the AI produced an error, and the AI could not debug it. Anyway, with the improved prompt, the result was correct. So I moved to the following questions, and what I noticed is that the responses were very brief, way too brief. Moreover, it didn't produce figures to go with the answers. For instance, question 3 explicitly suggests the use of figures, but Meta did not generate any. As the questions were becoming more and more complex, this AI was definitely falling behind. Reached question 6, it produced a code that did not run, and the AI was not able to solve the error. In the end, I gave up, as the quality of the responses was anyway poor in comparison to the other AIs. So the result is that Meta AI failed my coursework. Okay, next up we have Claude AI. Now, Claude is a weird one. Like Meta AI, Claude did the same mistakes and required the same clarification on question 1. But then I discovered that Claude has a weird limitation on the complexity of the conversation that can happen in a single chat. Given the complexity of the coursework, I reached this limit already at question 2. The workaround was to start a new chat session for question 3, but then Claude had limited context and the performance degraded. For instance, Claude started to use the scikit library, which was forbidden. Moreover, Claude reached the limit again just answering question 3. Thus, I decided to stop it. Claude showed potential, and the response to question 2 was good, but the limitations of the free plan are too strong to make Claude a good AI for this task. So the result is that Claude failed my coursework. Next up, we have ChatGPT-4. ChatGPT is the first AI that we see today that was able to reach the end of the coursework, even though it was not able to solve all the questions. Like Meta AI and Claude AI, it made the error in question 1, error which was not able to solve by itself and required an improved prompt. Quite annoyingly, ChatGPT made in question 5 the same error that it did in question 1, and weirdly, this time ChatGPT was not able to solve it with an improved prompt. But question 5 counts only 5% of the total mark, so I decided to just leave the compilation error in the code and move forward. Now we reach question 6, which, if you remember, was the end of the line for Meta. Well, ChatGPT made the same coding mistake of Meta, but differently from Meta, ChatGPT was able to solve it. So I continued. Once again, ChatGPT made a compilation error in part of question 7, which I left in the submission, and finally ChatGPT solved the last question correctly. So to recap, of the 8 questions, ChatGPT solved eventually 6, and produced unsolved compilation errors in 1.5 questions. That was good enough for me. It is not a great performance, it was a bit annoying to use, but it could pass for a student submission. So I packed up this coursework, I invented a fake name, a fake ID number, I checked that there were no AI telltales, and sent the coursework to my teaching assistants for marking. I had 35 students in my course, and now I will tell you where the mark of ChatGPT was placed in the ranking. ChatGPT scored 28 out of 36. This is not a great performance. It is not a first-class mark, it is close to the bottom of the ranking, but still, ChatGPT performed better than 9 students. Well, this is starting to get problematic, but let's move on for now and move to the next AI that happens to be our last to test. So the winner of this little competition is Gemini 2.5 Pro, and wow, it completely smoked the competition. First of all, Gemini did not produce any error in the first question. With the most basic prompt, Gemini understood the dataset correctly and produced correct code immediately. This was the only AI tested to achieve this. Gemini was able to solve the entire coursework running only once into a compilation error in the infamous question 6. But Gemini was able to solve the compilation error by itself without any need for me to understand or help. Gemini provided excellent explanations and analysis throughout the entire coursework. Actually, Gemini's answers got better and better as the coursework progressed. It also formatted, upon request, the discussion and analysis in the markdown required for the submission, ready to be submitted. The explanations were at a level way beyond ChatGPT. While Claude's response to question 2 was maybe better, the responses of Gemini were consistently excellent. Now, this sounds like an ad for Google, but no, I'm not getting paid by Google for this. So I gave this coursework to my teaching assistants to know how Gemini would rank in the class. And the result is that Gemini 2.5 Pro ranked 4 out of 36. That's incredible. Only 3 students got a higher mark, and the first ranked student got just a mark 2.5% higher than Gemini. This means that potentially a student who has never studied optimization and did not even bother to read the coursework can copy-paste everything into Gemini and get at the top of the class. Honestly, all 4 results were surprising. My guess before doing this experiment was that all 4 AIs would perform similarly, and that their performance would be average, at around 20 out of 35. Instead, I was first surprised that many AIs could not solve the coursework, and then I was surprised by how good Gemini was in comparison. So what are the conclusions and implications of this experiment? It pains me to say it, but AI may be the death of this kind of coursework. Because, you know, even if most students would not just copy and paste from the AI, the mere possibility that a student who has no clue about the material can perform at the top of the class, while the majority of students who spend 2 months of their lives waiting on this would score way lower, means that this is not anymore a fair assessment. Now, I want to clarify that fundamentally, I do not give a damn about giving marks. Giving marks is not the reason why I do this job. I do this job to teach students, to make them learn new things. However, if the AI outperforms honest students, this becomes a fairness issue. It is simply unfair for me to give so many marks to an assessment where students who have no understanding can perform miles better than hardworking students. But then, what is the solution? Let's explore 3 possibilities. I call solution 1 the race. Now let me explain what I mean. Of course, this result may be just a fluke. Maybe my coursework happens to be easy to solve for Gemini because there is a lot of coding, or because classification is a very mainstream topic and maybe a slightly different coursework would not be as easy to solve by the AI. But I think the main point here is that because the different AIs performed so differently, from failing to acing the coursework, it is basically impossible for a professor to be sure that a coursework is not solvable by AI. A professor will need to test tens of different AI models and different versions of the same model. And the professor will need to retest the coursework every 2 months as new, better models are released. This is simply a race that cannot be won. Raising the AI is not a solution. This brings us to solution 2, the death of the coursework. In this solution, professors accept that coursework became a weaker form of assessment. There is a big fairness problem, and even if students do not copy-paste from the AI, the fact that students can use AI to improve their answers without necessarily understanding what they are writing makes the educational potential of this kind of coursework weaker. So we, professors, can just accept that we won't use this kind of coursework anymore to assess students. However, this is a very depressing outcome. Coursework are a very powerful educational tool. It is a way to give a complex problem to students and let them pour in their passion and intelligence. Students can be original and learn way more than what can be taught in class, by doing rather than listening. And coursework like these are the reasons why I did my PhD. When I was a student, I loved this kind of coursework because they were open-ended and they allow me to express my original thought and analysis capabilities. If these coursework had not existed when I was a student, I may not be here today. Let's move to solution 3. Incorporate the AI into the coursework. A possibility is to design new coursework for which the AI must be used. This means to design very complex courseworks that are so wide and challenging that cannot be solved without AI. And maybe this is what will happen, we will see. However, there are two issues at the moment. The first issue is that the impact of AI on teaching is so new that no one knows what an AI-enhanced coursework should look like. At the moment, we simply do not know what the right balance of difficulty is and whether this may risk to end up like solution one, that is, starting a race with AI. The second issue is that fundamentally, in a university, we're not here to give students impossible tasks. We're here to teach fundamental ideas. My purpose is to teach the students the ideas behind convex optimization. So giving them as a coursework the task of optimizing the flying path of a rocket on re-entry, just to make things challenging enough for the AI, does not help at all in teaching the fundamental ideas behind engineering and science. Now, the tech bros will blabber about how AI can simply let you do more than before, that it will make you learn more complex tasks. But this is like learning how to run by being carried on the shoulders of Usain Bolt. You may run 100 meters quite fast, but that does not mean that you know how to run. Even more, this may be a catastrophe for young children. These children may be carried around by Usain Bolt since the beginning of their journey, and they may never learn how to even walk. It will be years before we understand the true implications of the use of the AI in education and the effect that this will have on our intellective capabilities. But early research studies already show a degradation of problem-solving and creativity skills. So where are we left? Is this the death of this amazing educational tool? Are we going to evolve into AI-enhanced courseworks? And if so, what will they look like? I do not know. And you? I want to know what you think about all of this, so leave a comment down below, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching and see you next time.